Hi, my name is Lynn Griesmer, and I'd like to share with you some of what I've learned as I've campaigned to represent District 2 on Amherst's new town council. I began with a few central ideas I wanted to try out. First, that the transition to our new form of government will call on the best in us to listen, find common ground, and move our community forward. It's a unique moment, and we only have one chance for a good start. Second, that we need a more coherent approach to development, the quality of our neighborhoods, and the residential tax burden. I think most of us recognize that residential property taxes can't continue to bear so much of the burden for excellent schools and services. But broadening the tax base through economic development must serve our values and respect our small town character. Third, that sound stewardship is essential. Generations of taxpayers have invested in school, municipal, and library facilities consistent with our values. But many of these facilities are beyond their useful lives, and we must protect and or replace them to pass on a strong foundation for the future, not a growing list of unresolved problems. These ideas have struck a chord with many people and have led to some very rich conversations. So as we head toward the final election, I want to give you a better sense of what you can expect from me if you choose me for town council. My optimism about a positive transition has grown steadily. We sometimes hear that Amherst is a town divided, but my sense is that we are far less apart than we sometimes seem. The idea of a different kind of government has hung over us with some understandable uncertainty and contention. But now that the question of what our government will look like has been settled, I have found tremendous interest in engaging the big issues that will determine the success of our community. The critical first job for the council is making the conversation positive and productive, and my unwavering commitment is to promote open, informed, forthright, and respectful dialogue. On the question of economic development and broadening the tax base, the ideas are flying fast and thick. Concerns I've heard range from aesthetics to neighborhood fit to parking. To me, the common thread is the sense that development is currently occurring outside an effective framework that represents us. Zoning is confusing and often outdated, with consequences that seem unintended or out of sync. The connection with our master plan, which is supposed to reflect our values and expectations, seems broken. The new charter requires for the first time that the governing body adopt a master plan on behalf of the town and consider all zoning and development proposals in that context. So a second critical job for the council in partnership with the planning board is to engage the entire community, assess what works so far, and imagine how to overcome obstacles that remain. I will be a relentless advocate for hearing all voices, forging common vision that can earn broad support, and connecting the dots between our values and our zoning for projects, large and small. Finally, I found broad agreement that we need to attend to our public buildings, but also confusion about the trade-offs, timing, and sometimes a sense that the right conversations aren't happening. I've been working for years on these issues, and there is certainly no easy answer, but I believe we can find a way forward that brings the community together. The good news is that we have some savings for this purpose, but we will absolutely need to maximize possible state and private funding so that we can minimize the impact on local taxes. I will be a forceful advocate for financially and environmentally responsible capital planning that balances our priorities, and I will insist on transparent discussion of the choices we face and the connection among different projects. It would be a tremendous honor to serve on Amherst's new town council as one of two representatives from District 2. I am excited about continuing the conversation the campaign has started. I invite you to learn more about me on my website at lynnfordistrict2.org. And thank you, Amherst Media, and for all of you for being part of this important transition. Please vote on November 6th, and I hope you'll give me one of your votes for District 2. Thank you.